don't wait for your walking partner. Vete tú solo y gárate unos headphones. Y ahora you can download, you know, the Bible. You can hear the Bible on your esa cosa. Yeah. You can hear that, you know, or you can just put on some soft music and walk and pray. You don't have to be here kneeling down. Tú puedes caminar y hablar con Dios. In fact, it'd probably be better because you don't fall asleep. You know, a lot of times cuando estás orando ahí next to the bed, what happens? You get right off the bed and you just slide right down. You don't even brush your teeth ni nada y está hablando con el Señor. You know, sometimes you don't even wake up to wash your face. Right away, comienzas a pray. ¿Y qué pasa? Give it a few minutes y cuando menos acuerdas, you're falling asleep. So use a little common sense. Usa un poquito de sabiduría. And spend some time sitting down first. So that's the number one thing he did. I didn't share that Wednesday. And then after that, what the word says here, that he sat down and he wept, lloró. ¿Cuántos de nosotros lloramos por nuestros pecados? No lloramos porque no tenemos con qué pagar la luz. That's not the llorando I'm talking about. No lloramos porque no nos hacen caso nadie, ni que nadie nos quiere, y estamos llorando porque nos abandonaron, and we're crying for other... That's not the crying this is talking about. The crying it's talking about is because things are not going God's way for God. Nehemiah saw the situation and it was a mess and he cried for it. Él lloró por el pueblo de Dios. Tú debes de llorar por tus primos que se están yendo al infierno ahorita. Tú tienes primos, tienes hermanos. Tú tienes familiares, you got friends, you got relatives, that right now if they will get struck with a car outside and die, they go straight to hell. Those are the people you need to cry about. Jesus told the ladies that were crying when he was carrying the cross, he said, don't cry for me, cry for yourself and your children. Tú debes de llorar por ti, si no andas caminando bien con Dios. If you're not walking right with God, you need to weep about that. But I'm not talking about weeping that, you know, some people cry for anything. That's not the kind of crying he's talking about. Vas a llorar porque es algo que viene de adentro, de Dios. When he makes you see things. Listen, when you let the Holy Spirit show you the reality of things and the sad situation that sometimes we're in, you're going to cry about it. And it's the Spirit of God doing that. And that's his, it says that he mourned. Dice que estuvo en luto, estuvo triste. Muchos de nosotros queremos el gozo del Señor, pero no queremos primeramente lamentar por cómo hemos sido con Dios. Con nosotros mismos, con nuestra vida espiritual no la hemos cuidado. We haven't taken care of our spiritual life. We haven't been doing the things we need to do with God. We need to mourn. There's a time for joy. Ecclesiastes tells us in chapter 3. There's a time to cry and there's a time for joy. There's a time to be sad. There's a time to be joyful. Well, here, Nehemiah is speaking of the fact that there comes a time in your life where you have to sit down and cry about your sins. Now, I'm not talking that you're going to do this every single day. Because if you do this every single day, you're just going to flat fall into depression. There's got to be some joy in your life. But joy can't be there unless first you weep for what you've done for your sins. Algunos de ustedes que casi no vienen a la church, híjole, aquí les va. Pónganse los hijos. You gotta weep because you don't come. Because you don't want to come. Te gana el diablo.
That's right.
Pero para otras cosas, you're ready for work. You got to be there because it's important to you. Because if you don't go, you don't get paid. Y aquí en la church es like an extracurricular activity, you know. Si hay chance, vamos. Si no, no vamos. Pero no debe ser así. You see, that's a good determination of how your relationship with God. Si de veras amas al Señor, esto va a ser priority.
Amen.
Esto va a ser primordial en tu vida. You're not going to leave it. A ver si hay chance para el Señor later on. You know, a ver si no vienen los compadres. Diles que no vengan. Que vayan con alguien más. Y si vienen, no te avergüences del evangelio. Bring them to church.
Amen.
Says, oh, no, brother, no puede venir porque me cayó visita. I'm not trying, and some of you told me that I'm not really referring to you, but in a sense I am. Because a lot of us, you know, quién sabe quién sería, no me acuerdo, pero algunos me han dicho. Es que nos cayó visita, pero no pudimos venir. You're not honoring me by coming. You're honoring God and yourself.
That's right.
I don't mind si no vienes. You're not going to make me stop preaching. Yo voy a seguir adelante si vienes o no vienes. This is my calling, y yo le doy para adelante. Si no vienes tú, otros vienen.
That's right.
Pero yo quisiera que tú vengas también. But you need to put that as a priority in your life. Talk to your husband, talk to your wife, talk to your children. Sundays are for God.
Hallelujah.
No matter what happens. Wednesdays también.
Yes, that's right. Amen.
A ver, ¿cuántos clapearon? So I can take down your names.
Aplaudieron.
No, the roll call on Wednesday.
That's true.
You see, you have to make a priority. This is your life. Porque un día el diablo te va a querer atacar con una enfermedad. Y sabes qué, cuando tú estás bien afianzado del Señor, not because you're coming to church. I'm not telling you because you come to church, everything is fine. But when everything is fine, you are going to come to church. When everything is fine between you and God, tú vas a poner esa sección ahí para el Señor, ese tiempo. And when the devil wants to attack you with something in your family, a sickness or a tragedy or a crisis, sabes que no va a poder contigo. Porque tú tienes un lugar especial que nomás Dios puede ocupar en tu vida. And when you do, we're not talking about church attendance, I hope you don't get me wrong. But church attendance says a lot about your relationship with God. How would you guys feel if I don't show up here? Ah, no me voy a jugar golf. Hay que pedir que alguien va. Brother David. Brother David has an FN voice, ¿me entienden? He preaches good. So, pero no, this is. He's blushing. Déjelo. By the way, the ushers will be here Wednesday, I'm sure. Let me go to the next. If I wind up with no church at all. Let's go with anything else to be here. You guys don't know, when we started the Ballinger Church, no había nadie. Era nomás Diana y yo and the children. Our first service, not a single soul was there. And Gabriel was running around and yelling. And estaba chiquito. Así gritaba. Descontroladamente. Like he had no hope, you know? Oh, aquí está. But not to worry, ya se compuso. Now we're going to start the sermon, okay? Go to verse 5, Nehemiah 1:5. I want you to notice a pattern here, something really interesting that I was studying, and then I said, man, this is awesome.
Ay, Señor de mi vida. Where is he?
Okay, when Nehemiah started praying, ya vemos que he mourned, he fasted, and he prayed, and this is what he said in his prayer. Verse 5, he said, and said, I beseech thee, O Lord, God of heaven, the great and terrible God that keepeth covenant and mercy for them that love him and observe his commandments. Notice that he's not even asking for anything yet. He's not even praying the way we do. What is he doing? He's honoring God primero.
Amen.
I want you to notice that. A lot of our prayers, Lolito, entra petition, Señor, paga mi bill, Señor, que se componga la señora, ¿verdad? Señor, que se componga el esposo, y Señor. And we never take time to honor God.